First of all, thanks for being here in my YouTube channel. So in this topic number 5 for the preparation of RRB Junior Engineer exam, we are going to solve 20 plus question based on the topic called blood relation. So always blood relation will be the most important topic for all the competitive exams. So minimum you can able to see 1 mark from blood relation and maximum for 3 marks. So now let me move on to all the 20 plus important questions. Question number 1. Rajiv is the brother of Atul. So Atul brother is Rajiv. So Atul is having a brother, that is Rajiv. Second point, Sonia is the sister of Sunil. So Sunil sister is Sonia, but we don't know where is Sunil. So let me keep the point as it is. Third point, Atul is the son of Sonia. So Sonia's son will be Atul. So Sonia is having a son, that is Atul. And in the second point, they have clearly told that Sonia is the sister of Sunil. So Sunil's sister will be Sonia. And Sonia's son will be Atul. And Atul's brother will be Rajiv. That's it. So what is the question? How is Rajiv related to Sonia? Which means from Sonia, our target to find what is the relation of Rajiv. So from Sonia, the relation of Rajiv will be the son. Because we already know that Sonia's son will be Atul and Atul's brother will be Rajiv. So definitely both the person should be the son of Sonia. So finally we can say that Sonia's son will be Rajiv. This will be the answer for question number 1. Question number 2. Sita is the niece of Ashok. So listen here. Ashok's niece will be Sita. So if someone is, Ashok is calling someone as a niece, then definitely Ashok should have brother or sister and their daughter should be Sita. Only then Ashok can call Sita as a niece. Next point. Ashok's mother is Lakshmi. So what they are saying is Lakshmi is the mother of Ashok. So Ashok's mother will be Lakshmi. Kalyani is the Lakshmi's mother. Oh my god. Kalyani is the Lakshmi's mother. So Lakshmi is having a mother called as Kalyani. I think it goes for 4th generation, right? 1st generation, 2nd generation, 3rd. Okay, next point. Kalyani's husband is Gopal. So Kalyani is having an husband. It is Gopal. Parvati is the mother-in-law of Gopal. So what they are saying is Gopal is calling Parvati as mother-in-law. And we already know that Gopal is married to Kalyani. Now Gopal is calling Parvati as a mother-in-law. So definitely Kalyani mother should be Parvati. So only then where Gopal can call Parvati as mother-in-law. I think it goes for the 3rd or 4th generation, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4th generation. Okay, what will be the last point? How Sita is related to Gopal. How Sita is related to Gopal, which means from Gopal, our target to find what is the relation of Sita. So listen here, from Gopal, Lakshmi will be the daughter, right? So Ashok will be the grandson. But when you look into Sita, it goes to the 3rd generation. Only up to 2nd generation, we used to call grandfather, grandmother, granddaughter, grandson. If it goes for the 3rd generation, then we usually use a word great-grandfather, great-grandmother. So now our target to find from Gopal, what is the relation of Sita? So from Gopal, the relation of Sita will be great-granddaughter. So this will be the answer for question number 2. If it crosses 3rd generation, then definitely you should use a word called great. So great granddaughter. Got it, friends? So from Gopal, Lakshmi will be the daughter. From Gopal, Ashok will be the grandson. From Gopal, Sita will be great, because another generation. So great granddaughter. So this will be the answer for question number 2. Question number 3. Seema is daughter-in-law of Sudhir. So Sudhir is calling Seema as a daughter-in-law. So definitely Sudhir should have a son. Only then this son should be married to Seema. So only then we can say Sudhir can call Seema as a daughter-in-law. So definitely Sudhir should have a son and that son should be married to Seema. So only then we can say Sudhir will call Seema as a daughter-in-law. And sister-in-law of Ramesh. See here, Ramesh sister-in-law is Seema. So Ramesh sister-in-law is Seema. So either Ramesh should be the another son here, or otherwise we can make it as another son there. So let me keep the point as it is. Next point, Mohan is the son of Sudhir. So Sudhir is having a son, Mohan. Okay, but we can place either Mohan here, one possible, or otherwise we can have another son here as a Mohan. So we don't know exactly whether Mohan is married to Seema, right? Next point. What the next point saying is, and only brother of Ramesh. Listen carefully. They are clearly mentioning that Mohan is the son of Sudhir and the only brother of Ramesh. So Ramesh is having a only brother, that is Mohan. And we already know that Ramesh is calling Seema as a sister-in-law. So definitely we can't able to place Ramesh here. Only possible I should place Ramesh here. And we know that Ramesh is having a only brother, that is Mohan. So definitely Mohan should be married to Seema. No other way. Only then we can say Ramesh will call Seema as sister-in-law. And Ramesh is having a only brother, that is Mohan. Got it? So what is the question? Find the relation between Seema and a Mohan. So the relation between Seema and Mohan will be husband and wife. So this will be the answer for question number 3. Question number 4. Suresh's sister is the wife of Ram. So Suresh is having a sister and that person will be the wife of Ram, right? So let me do one thing. Suresh is having a sister and this girl will be the wife of Ram. Got it? So Suresh's sister, this girl is the wife of Ram. Next point, Ram is Rani's brother. So Rani's brother is a Ram. So Rani is having a brother, that is a Ram. So Ram's father is Madhur. So Ram is having a father and the person name is Madhur. Sheetal is Ram's grandmother. So see here, Ram is having a grandmother which is called as Sheetal. So definitely we already know that Ram is having a father, that is Madhur. So we can say another generation. So Ram is calling Sheetal as grandmother. Reema is Sheetal's daughter-in-law. So listen here. Sheetal is calling Reema as a daughter-in-law. And we already know that Ram is having a father, that is Madhur. And Mathur mother will be Sheetal. Now what Sheetal is calling Reema as a daughter-in-law. So definitely Madhu should be married to Reema. So only then we can say Sheetal can call Reema as a daughter-in-law. Got it? Okay. Last point. Rohit is Rani's brother's son. So Rani brother's son will be Rohit. So definitely we know that Rani is having a only brother, that is Ram. So Rani brother son will be Rohit. That's it, right? So what is the question? Who is Rohit to Suresh? So our target to find from Suresh, what is the relation of Rohit? So listen here, from Suresh, we know that Suresh is having a sister. So sister son is called as a Rohit. So the relation will be nephew. If it is a girl, then we usually call it as niece. If it is a boy, then it's a nephew. So from Suresh, the relation of Rohit will be sister's son. So sister's son should be called as a nephew. So answer for question number 4 will be nephew. Question number 5. Preeti has a son named Arun. So Preeti is having a son name called Arun. Next point. Ram is Preeti's brother. So Preeti is having a brother, that is Ram. Next, Neeta too has a daughter named Reema. So Neeta is having a daughter that is named called Reema. But we don't know where is Neeta and Reema. So let me keep the point as it is. Next point, Neeta is Ram's sister. So Ram is having a sister that is Neeta. Right, Neeta. Yeah, Neeta. So Ram's sister is Neeta. And then the second point, they have clearly told that Neeta too has a daughter name called Reema. So Neeta is having a daughter, that is Reema. And the last point, what is the then question, right? What is the Arun's relation to Reema? So our target to find what is the relation from Arun to Reema. I think from Arun, Neeta will be aunt. Got it? Because all these three will be brothers and sisters. So from Arun, Preeti will be mother. So from Arun, Neeta will be the aunt. So aunt, daughter will be Reema. So definitely they both are cousins. So we can say answer for question number 5 will be cousins. Question number 6. Ravi's father has a son Rohit who has an aunt Lakshmi. So listen here, first point, Ravi's father has a son. So Ravi's father has a son Rohit. So Ravi is having a father. So Ravi's father has a son, that is Rohit. So definitely Ravi and Rohit should be brothers. Got it? Because Ravi's father is having a son, that is Rohit. So definitely they both should be a brothers. Who has an aunt? Lakshmi. So Ravi's father is having an aunt called as Lakshmi. So which will be sister, right? So Ravi's father's sister should be definitely Lakshmi. Only then Ravi can say Lakshmi as an aunt. Next point. Who has an husband? Rao. So this person Lakshmi is having an husband, that is Rao, whose father-in-law is Mohan. So Rao father-in-law is Mohan. So definitely we know that these two persons are a married couple. Now this person is calling Mohan as a father-in-law. So definitely Lakshmi father should be Mohan. So only then we can say Rao will call Mohan as a father-in-law. What is the question? What is the relation of Mohan to Ravi? So our target to find what is the relation from Ravi to Mohan. So which means from Ravi, we know that Lakshmi will be the mother. So mother, father will be Mohan. So the answer will be grandfather. Easiest question. So from Ravi, the relation of Mohan will be grandfather. Question number 7. Raghu and Babu are twins. So Raghu and Babu. So both are twins, right? So Babu. Babu's sister is Reema. So Babu is having a sister, that is Reema. Reema's husband is Rajan. So Reema is married and Reema is having an husband, that is Rajan. Raghu's mother is Lakshmi. So Raghu is having a mother and mother's name is Lakshmi. Lakshmi's husband is Rajesh. So Lakshmi is married to a person, Rajesh. Everything is a direct statement. So what is the question? How is Rajesh related to Rajan? So where is Rajesh is here, Rajan is here. So what is our target? Our target to find what is the relation from Rajan to Rajesh, right? So from Rajan to Rajesh. So listen carefully. All these three will be brothers and sisters because we know that there are twins. And Babu is having a sister Reema. So definitely from Reema, Lakshmi will be mother. So from Reema, Rajesh will be father. Now a target to find from Rajan, what is the relation of Rajesh? So from Rajan, Rajesh will be the wife father. So wife father should be called it as father-in-law. So answer for question number 7, father-in-law. Question number 8. Sheila is Ravi's sister-in-law. So Ravi is having a sister-in-law, that is Sheila. It can be Ravi's wife's sister or it can be someone. So better we can keep the point as it is. Let me move on to the next point. Ram is Ravi's brother. So now Ravi is having a brother, that is Ram. So Ram's wife is Sheila. So now listen here. Ram is having a wife, that is Sheila. So only then we can say Ravi will call Sheila as a sister-in-law. So now Ravi is having a brother Ram and Ram is married to Sheila. So according to point number 1, Ravi will call Sheila as a sister-in-law. Next point, Deepa is Ravi's sister. So Ravi is having a sister that is called Deepa. Okay. Deepa's mother is Shanti. So Deepa is having a mother that is Shanti. Last point, how Sheila related to Shanti. So our target to find how Sheila related to Shanti. Listen here, we know that Ravi is having a brother Ram, Ravi is having a sister Deepa. So definitely all the three should be brothers and sisters and their mother is Shanti. But now what is our target from Sheila? What is the relation of Shanti? So from Sheila, Ram will be the husband. So husband mother will be Shanti. So husband mother should be called it as mother-in-law. So answer for question number 8 will be mother-in-law. Look at the question, how Sheila is related to Shanti. So listen here, our target to find from Shanti, what is the relation of Sheila, right? So from Shanti, the relation of Sheila will be daughter-in-law. From Sheila, the relation of Shanti will be mother-in-law. So got it? So now the question says to Shanti. The reading of question is most important. How is Sheila related to Shanti, right? If it is to Shanti, then our target to find from Shanti, what is the relation of Sheila? So from Shanti, the relation of Sheila will be daughter-in-law. Question number 9. Tarun is the father of Rohit. So Rohit is having a father, Tarun. Rohit is the brother of Kala. So Kala brother will be Rohit. Okay, so Kala is having a brother, that is Rohit. Kala is the wife of Dilip. So Kala is a girl, right? Because Dilip is calling Kala as a wife. So we can say Kala will be a female person. So now Dilip is married to Kala. Got it? Last point. How Dilip related to Rohit? So from Rohit, our target to find what is the relation of Dilip. We know that from Rohit, Kala will be the sister. So sister, husband will be Dilip. So sister, husband should be call it as a brother-in-law. So brother-in-law will be the answer for question number 9. Question number 10. Rajiv is the brother of Arun. So Arun is having a brother, that is Rajiv. Sonia is the sister of Sunil. So Sunil is having a sister, Sonia. Okay, next point. Arun is the son of Sonia. So Arun is the son of Sonia, which is, so Sonia son should be Arun. And in the second point, they have told that Sonia is having a sister, that is Sunil. So that's it, right? What is our target? How Rajiv is related to Sonil. So from Sonil, our target to find what is the relation of Rajiv. So from Sonil, the relation of Sonia will be sister. Sister son will be Rajiv. Then sister son should be call it as nephew. If it is a girl, then we used to call it as a niece. So answer for question number 10 will be nephew. So from Sonil, Sonia will be the sister and sister son will be Rajiv. So we can say answer will be nephew. This will be the answer for question number 10. Question number 11. Karan has a brother, Prem. So Karan is having a brother, that is Prem. So next point, and a sister, Nisha. So Karan is having a brother, Prem, and another sister called Nisha. So Karan's wife is Naj. So Karan is married and this person, Karan, is having a wife, that is Naj. And as a daughter, Naksha. So they both is having a daughter and her name called Naksha. Okay. Next point, Naksha got married with Nisha's son Akbar. So listen here, the person Naksha, we know that Naksha is a girl because they have clearly told that Karan Naj's daughter will be Naksha. And this person Naksha is married to Nisha's son, that is Akbar. So Nisha is having a son Akbar and this person Akbar is married with Naksha, right? Got it. So they both are a married couples. So what is the question? And as a baby girl, Riya. So they both have a baby girl called Riya. So they have mentioned as a girl. Okay. So what is the question says? What is the relation between Naksha and Nisha? So Naksha and Nisha. I think only based on the option we can mark the answer. Because listen here, from Naksha, we can say the relation will be aunt. And from Nisha, the relation of Naksha will be niece. One relation, aunt and niece. Because we know that Naksha, father will be Karan and Karan's sister will be Nisha. Either we can call Naksha and Nisha as an aunt or otherwise niece. One relation. I think if we go like this, Naksha's husband is Akbar and Akbar mother is Nisha. So either from Naksha we can call Nisha as mother-in-law or otherwise from Nisha to Naksha called as daughter-in-law. I think only based on the option we should mark the answer, right? Either we can say niece and aunt or otherwise daughter-in-law or mother-in-law. Got it? So this will be the answer for question number 11. Question number 12. Babita is Ajay's wife. So Babita is Ajay's wife. So Ajay is having a wife and this girl is called as Babita. Okay. And Chiranjeev is Divya's father. So Divya is having a father called Chiranjeev. Okay, next point. If Ajay's mother-in-law is wife of Divya's grandfather. So what they are saying is if Ajay's mother-in-law. So if Ajay want to call someone as a mother-in-law, then definitely it should be Babita's wife. Only then we can say Ajay can call this person as a mother-in-law. Got it? So what they are saying is Ajay mother-in-law is wife of Divya's grandfather. So Divya is having a grandfather and this grandfather wife, where Ajay is calling as a mother-in-law. Friends, got it. And in the second point, they have told that Chiranjeev is a Divya's father. So Divya is having a father that is Chiranjeev. So very interesting. Listen the words carefully. The question plays a major role, right? How we read a question is most important. In the second point, what they are saying is, if Ajay's mother-in-law is wife of Divya's grandfather, Ajay mother-in-law should be definitely his wife mother. So Ajay mother-in-law is a wife of Divya's grandfather. Divya grandfather wife, where Ajay is calling as mother-in-law. And they have already mentioned that Divya is having a father that is Chiranjeev. Okay. So definitely they both should be a brothers and sisters. Got it. So what is the next point? Then what is the relation of Babita and Chiranjeev's wife? So Chiranjeev is having a wife, but they didn't mention the name. So our target to find what is the relation of Babita. So from Babita to Chiranjeev wife. So from Babita, Chiranjeev will be brother. So brother wife should be called it as sister-in-law. Very interesting question, an important question. So sister-in-law will be the answer for question number 12. Question number 13. Prema is Ajay's sister. So Ajay is having a sister that is Prema. Benita is Ajay's mother. So Ajay is having a mother called as Benita. Okay. Benjamin is Benita's father. So Benita's father is Benjamin. Next point. Leela is Benjamin's mother. It goes for the third generation. Listen here. Benjamin's mother is Leela. Got it? Leela, right? Benjamin mother is Leela, Benita mother is Benjamin, and Ajay mother is Benita. So it goes for fourth generation. Just now I have told in the first question, if it goes beyond third generation, then we usually use a word great grandfather, great grandmother. Got it? So what is the question? How Prema is related to Leela? So from Leela, our target to find what is the relation of Prema. So definitely it should be great granddaughter. So this word great determines for the third or the fourth generation, right? Up to second generation, we usually call this grandfather, grandmother. If it goes on to third generation or fourth generation, we use a word called great grandmother, great granddaughter. Similarly, great grandson and great granddaughter. So answer for question number 13, from Leela, the relation of Prema will be great granddaughter. Question number 14, Anand is son of Prema. So Prema is having a son that is Anand. Rajiv is brother of Prema. So Prema's brother will be Rajiv. Neha is daughter of Reshmi. So Reshmi daughter is Neha. But we don't know where Neha is. Okay, next point. Neha is sister of Rajiv. So Rajiv sister is Neha. And in the third point, Neha is daughter of Rashmi. So Rashmi daughter will be Neha, right? So got it. I think that's it. What is the question they're asking? How is Anand related to Rashmi? So from Rashmi, our target to find what is the relation of Anand. And we already know that these three are brothers and sisters, and their mom will be Rashmi. So from Rashmi, Prema will be his daughter. So daughter son will be Anand. So we can say answer will be grandson. Got it? From Reshma, where Prema will be the daughter. So daughter son will be Anand. So we can say answer for question number 14 will be grandson. Question number 15. Golu is son of Bola. Okay, so Bola son will be Golu. Sheetal is daughter of Golu. So Golu is having a daughter that is Sheetal. Okay. Chitra is a daughter of Dilip. So Chitra is the daughter of Dilip, but we don't know where is Dilip here. Next point. Dilip is brother of Bola. So Bola is having a brother that is Dilip. And as per the previous point, Dilip is having a daughter called as Chitra. Okay. How Chitra related to Sheetal? So from Sheetal, our target to find the relation of Chitra. We can definitely say from Sheetal, where Bolu will be grandfather and all are a single family. So we can definitely say from Sheetal, the relation of Chitra will be aunt. So no doubt about it, because you can clearly say where Dilip will be the bowler's brother. So definitely all these relation will comes under a single family. So we can say from Sheetal, the relation of Chitra will be aunt. Question number 16. Chanda is wife of Bharat. So Bharat wife will be Chanda. Mohan is the son of Chanda. So Chanda's son will be Mohan. Ashish is the brother of Bharat. So Bharat is having a brother, a name called Ashish. And the father of Dhruv. So Dhruv father will be Ashif, right? So Dhruv is calling a father as Ashif. So they both are a married couple. Bharat is having a brother Ashish. And Dhruv father will be Ashish, and Chand son will be Mohan. That's it. Okay. So what is the question? How is Mohan related to Dhruv? So our target to find the relation between Dhruv and Mohan, definitely it should be a cousins, right? Because from Dhruv, where Chandra will be his aunt, so aunt son will be Mohan. So aunt son should be call it as a cousins. So definitely these two will call it as a cousins. Question number 17. Sandeep has a brother named Ankur. So Sandeep is having a brother called as Ankur. Sandeep is the son of Kishan. So Kishan's son will be Sandeep. So Kishan's son will be Sandeep. What is called? Baliger. Okay. Baliger is Kishan's father. So Kishan is having a father called Baliger. Okay. And that's it, right? Okay. What is the question? How is Ankur related to Baliger? So from Baliger, our target to find what is the relation of Ankur. It is easy, right? Because from Baliger, we know that Kishan will be the son, and son's son is called as an Ankur. So definitely it should be a grandson. So grandson will be the answer for question number 17. Question number 18. Abhishek is Yomkesh brother. Okay, Yomkesh brother. So Yomkesh brother will be Abhishek. And next point. And Vimal is Jack's father. So Jack is having a father Vimal, but we don't know where to place it. Let it be. Next point. Ella is Yomkesh mother. So Yomkesh mother will be Ella. And Abhishek is Jack's brother. So Jack brother is Abhishek, right? So Jack brother is Abhishek. And the second point, what they have told us, Jack's father will be Vimal. So Jack father will be Vimal. So definitely they both should be a married couple. Why? Because this Yomkesh call Ella as a mother, and now Jack is calling Vimal as a father, and we already know that these both have been brothers. So definitely Ella and Vimal should be a married couple, husband and wife. So what is the question? The same. How is Ella related to Vimal? So Ella related to Vimal will be husband and wife. So this will be the answer for question number 18. Question number 19. Aryan has a brother named Bishnu. So Bishnu brother will be Aryan. Aryan is the son of Chetan. So Chetan's son is Aryan. So Chetan is having a son, that is Aryan. Dev is Chetan's father. So Chetan's father will be a Dev. Okay. In terms of relation, what is the relation between Bishnu of Dev? So of Dev, which means from Dev, our target to find what is the relation of Vishnu. I think from Dev, where Chetan will be the son. So son will be Vishnu, which is call it as a grandson. So easiest question. So answer for question number 19 will be grandson. Question number 20. Sumit is the son of Rahul. So Rahul is having a son, this Sumit. Rahul is the brother of Ankit. So Ankit brother will be Rahul. Smita is wife of Ankit. So what is Ankit wife will be Smita. And the last point, how Sumit related to Ankit, which means from Ankit our target to find what is the relation of Sumit. It's easy, because from Ankit Rahul will be brother. So brother son will be Sumit, should be call it as a nephew. If it is a girl, then we can say niece. So from Ankit, Sumit will be his brother son, should be called it as a nephew. So this will be the answer for the last 20th question.
So all the 20 questions that we have solved now is an easy to medium level, not a difficult question, because in most of the railway exams you will see an easiest blood relation question. Everything will be easy. You have to know the basics 100% so that you can easily crack the question. So practice more and more number of blood relation directions, arrangements, syllogism, jumbling like that, so that you can easily get into the stage 1 RRB exams. So thank you so much for watching this video. In the next video, we can solve some question on the blood relation that is based on pointing to a photograph, right? That's also important. So let me see 20 or 30 questions and lesson number 6. So thank you so much for watching this video. And if you really like it, share it to your friends, those who are preparing for a competitive exams. So thank you so much. Bye.